and God called her then. He had a plan. Because they could not get to him, he would go to them himself.
For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. So God made a plan to prepare their hearts for him to give. He sent an angel to a priest named Zechariah with a message.
The angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you are to call him John. He will bring many of the people of Israel back to the Lord their God. He will go before the Lord in the spirit and power of Elijah, to make ready the people prepared for the Lord."
Through John, God prepared the world for himself. John told the people to turn from their darkness. He told them what God was like so they could recognize him when he came.
Prepare the way for the Lord. Make straight paths for him. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill made low. The crooked road shall become straight, the rough way smooth, and all the people will see God's salvation. was ready. God would come, but not in the way the people had expected. He did not come as a mighty king or as a mysterious force. He came as a baby, born to a woman named Mary.
In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you."
God was teaching his people about himself. He does not come with force, but with humility and tenderness. He does not come through human action or will, but by his own perfect plan and loving power. Through Mary, God taught his people how to receive him with grateful surrender.
"I am the Lord's servant," Mary responded. "May your word to me be fulfilled."
Yeah.
God had done it. Jesus, Emmanuel, had come for his people once and for all. Though the world did not know that anything had changed, everything had.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger.
Though the world did not yet know the good news, heaven could not contain its joy. The angels were amazed at the beauty of God's plan and the depth of his love. An angel announced the good news to the shepherds, and immediately all heaven was lit up with rejoicing over what God had done.
Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to whom his favor rests."